Today's topic, zeros of polynomial functions and their multiplicities. Example, find the zeros of the function, then state the multiplicity. F of x is equal to x cubed minus 8x squared plus 16x. Factor the right side. There is a common factor. The common factor is x, factor it out. So we have f of x is equal to x times the quantity x squared minus 8x plus 16. X squared minus 8x plus 16 is a perfect square trinomial. So this can be factored as x minus 4 and x minus 4. So we have now f of x is equal to x times the quantity x minus 4 times the quantity x minus 4. You can check this one, x times x, x squared. Negative 4x plus negative 4x is negative 8x. Negative 4 times negative 4 is positive 16. The right side can be written as x times the quantity x minus 4 close parenthesis squared. Then we apply the zero product property. If AB is equal to zero, then A is equal to zero or B is equal to zero. The factor A is equated to zero and the second factor B is equated to zero. If there is another factor, it should be equated to zero. So, we are going to equate x to 0 and then x minus 4 to 0 and then x minus 4 to 0 and then solve for x. X is already 0 here. Transpose negative 4 to the other side and change the sign. So we have x is equal to 4 and then here x is equal to 4. The zero of a function is the x value that when plugged into the function will make the function zero. If you plug in zero here or replace x by zero, the right side will become zero. If you plug in 4 here or replace x by 4, 4 minus 4 becomes 0, 4 minus 4 becomes 0, the right side will become 0. The zeros of the function therefore are 0, 4, and 4. The two distinct zeros of the function are 0 and 4. Multiplicity is the number of times a particular number is a zero or root for a given polynomial. Zero is a root only once, and four is a root twice. So, therefore, zero as a multiplicity of one, and four as a multiplicity of two.